Good morning students, in this class I'll be doing class 10 CBSE syllabus third chapter pair of linear equation in two variables. One exercises I have completed. Now this is the second exercise. Fourth sum is which of the following pairs of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent. If consistent, obtain the solution graphically. So these are the two equations given. So the first equation is x plus y is equal to 5. Second equation is 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. So first we will check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. Okay, so we will check this a1 and a2. So here a1 is 1, b1 is 1 and c1 is minus 5. And a2 is 2, b2 is 2 and c2 is minus 10. Then when we are finding the ratios of this, a1 by a2 is 1 by 2 we get. Then b1 by b2 is also equal to 1 by 2. And c1 by c2 is also equal to 1 by 2. That is minus 5 by minus 10 will be equal to 1 by 2. So here we are getting all the ratios are equal. a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So the system of given equations are consistent. So they form coincident lines. Okay. So they are consistent. So the given equations are consistent. Consistent. They form coincident lines. Since it is coincident lines. Coincident lines. Since they form coincident lines, we have to draw the graph for the given equation. So for drawing graph, we need coordinate points to plot it in the graph. So first equation is x plus y. First equation is x plus y is equal to 5. So in this, we will take y is equal to 5 minus x. Okay, then we will draw a tabular column for this. So we'll draw a tabular column and find the coordinate points of the given equation. So we will find 4 points for this x and y. So here y is equal to 5 minus x. So when we are taking x value as 1, y is equal to 5 minus 1, that is equal to 4. Then if x is equal to 2, then y is equal to 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3. Then if x is equal to 3, then y is equal to 5 minus 3, that is equal to 2. Then if x is equal to 4, y is equal to 5 minus 4, that is equal to 1. So these are the points we will take. So if x is 1, y is 4. If x is 2, y is 3. If x is 3, y is 2. And if x is 4, y is 1. So this is for the first equation. Then if we take second equation, 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. So when we divide the whole equation by 2, the same thing only we'll get. So x plus y is equal to 5. So the same equation only we'll get. So the same coordinate points we will plot. Since the equations are same, we will plot the same thing. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So if x is 1, y is 4, x is 2, y is 3, x is 3, y is 2, x is 4 and y is equal to 1. Now we will plot these points in the graph. In the graph we will be plotting this two equations. So when we plot it in the graph, we will take x-axis and y-axis we will take. So this one is, we will take it as 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is x-axis and y-axis is also 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we will plot this in the graph. So if x is 1, y is equal to 4. So this one is, the coordinate point is 1, 4. Then if x is 2, y is 3. So this one is 2, 3. Then 3, 2. 3, 2. Then 4, 1. Then 4, 1. So these are the points we will plot. When I join this, I'll get a straight line for this equation. So the same points will be plotting for the next equation also. That is x plus y is equal to 5. If x value is 1, y value is 4. If x value is 2, y value is 3. If x value is 3, y value is 2. That is 3, 2. And the last one is also, last one is 4, 1. So this, since it is coincident line, both the points will be lying one above the other. It will be coincident. Okay, so this is the graph. So we obtained the solution for this graph graphically. Now second sum. X minus y is equal to 8. 3x minus 3y is equal to 16. Okay, so first we will find a1, a2 and all. So first equation, x minus y is equal to 8. So for this, a1 is equal to 1. b1 is equal to minus 1. c1 is equal to minus 8. Then second equation is 3x minus 3y is equal to 16. So this one, a1 is equal to 3. Sorry, a2. a2 is equal to 3. b2 is equal to minus 3. And c2 is equal to minus 16. Okay, so now we will find the ratios. a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 3. b1 by b2 is equal to minus 1 by minus 3. That is equal to 1 by 3. And c1 by c2 is equal to minus 8 by minus 16. That is equal to 1 by 2. So what we are getting when we are equating the ratios, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. So if we are getting this condition, they form parallel lines. Since they are parallel lines, they are inconsistent. They are parallel lines and inconsistent. Parallel line and inconsistent. They are inconsistent. Okay. So in this first equation, 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. 4x minus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0. So in this, a1 is equal to 2. b1 is equal to 1. c1 is equal to minus 6. And a2 is equal to 4. b2 is equal to minus 2. And c2 is equal to minus 4. So now we will find the ratios. a1 by a2 is equal to 2 by 4. That is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Then b1 by b2 is equal to 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Then c1 by c2 is equal to minus 6 by minus 4. That is equal to 3 by 2. So when we are comparing the ratios, we are getting a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. So a1 by a2 is 1 by 2. b1 by b2 is minus 1 by 2. So we are getting a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. So they are consistent and they form intersecting lines. So they are consistent. They are consistent. They are consistent and intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. So we need to find the solution graphically. So we need to find the solution of this graphically. So first we need to find the solutions. So first one is 2x plus y. 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Okay. So when we take this y here, y is equal to 6 minus 2x. Okay. So now we will take x values as 0. So if we are taking x value as 0, then y is equal to 6 minus 0, we will get 6. Okay. Then if x is equal to 1, then y is equal to 6 minus 2, that is equal to 4. Then if x is equal to 2, then y is equal to 6 minus 2 2s are 4, that is equal to 2. So these are the solutions of the given equation x and y. So 0, if x is 0, y is 6. If x is 1, y is 4. If x is 2, y is also equal to 2. So the same way we will find for the second one also. So second one is 4x minus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0. So here minus 2y is equal to 4 minus 4x. So whole thing I am dividing it by 2. So this one is minus y. If you want to keep, you can keep it as it is for my convenience. Since all terms have 2 as a factor, I am dividing throughout by 2. So minus y is equal to 2 minus 2x. Okay. So now I will get y is equal to 2x minus 2. Okay. So now x value, if it is 0, then y is equal to, if x value is 0, y value is equal to minus 2. Y value is equal to minus 2. Then if x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 minus 2, that is equal to 0. Then if x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2, 2s are 4, minus 2, that is equal to 2. Okay, so we will substitute this in the tabular column. So in the tabular column, when we are substituting this x and y values, so x, y, so if x is 0, 1 and 2, so if x is 0, y value is minus 2, if x is 1, y value is 0, if x is 2, y is also equal to 2. So now we will plot this in the graph. So in the graph, we will plot these points. So when we are plotting this, so this one will be 1, 2, 3, 4. This is x axis and this one is y axis. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 4, 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here also 5, 6. Okay. So first one is 0, 6. So x is 0 and y is 6 means we will get the point here. This is 0, 6. Then next one is 1, 4. 1, 4. This point is 1, 4. 2, 2. The next point is 2, 2, 2. So we will join these three points. So we will get a line like this. Straight line. Okay. Then next one is second equation. So this equation is 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. That equation. Then second equation, x is 0 and y is minus 2. So y is minus 2 means I will get minus 2 here. Okay, so this is 1 and this one is minus 1 and this one is minus 2. So x is 0 and y is minus 2 will be here. At this point we get, that is 0, minus 2. Then 1, 0. 1, 0 will be here. 1, 0. Then next one is 2, 2. So 2, 2 will be here. Okay, so when I join this, these two lines intersect at this point. So this is the solution of the equation 2, 2. Since they are intersecting lines, the both the lines intersect at this point, that is 2, 2. This is the solution for the given equation. So the solution is, the solution is 2, 2. 2, 2. Solution is 2, 2. Next sum is 2x minus 2y minus 2 is equal to 0. 4x minus 4y minus 5 is equal to 0. So here a1 is 2, b1 is minus 2 and c1 is also minus 2. then A2 is 4, B2 is minus 4 and C2 is minus 5. Now we will find the ratios. So A1 by A2 is equal to 2 by 4, that is equal to 1 by 2. Then B1 by B2 is equal to minus 2 by minus 4. That is equal to, minus will get cancelled, we will get 1 by 2. Then C1 by C2 is equal to minus 2 by minus 5. That is equal to 2 by 5. So when we are comparing the ratios, what we are getting? A1 by B2 is equal to, these two are equal, is equal to B1 by B2, not equal to C1 by C2. So C1 by C2 is not equal. Okay, so these are parallel lines and they are inconsistent. So therefore, the given lines form parallel lines. Given lines form parallel lines and they are inconsistent. So with this, I have completed today's class. So whatever doubts you have, you message me in the comment box. Thank you.